What's up internet, I am Manish from rebellionwriter.com where we make learning SQL, PLSQL and Oracle database fun. In the previous video, we learnt about packages in Oracle database, their architecture and the syntax. So today, we will take a step ahead and learn how to create PLSQL packages in Oracle database. In order to make the concept of creating PLSQL package easy to understand, I will create a package which will consist of a PLSQL function and a stored procedure. Both the function and the procedure are independent from each other and work as a standalone unit. So without further ado, let's start the tutorial and learn how to create PLSQL package in Oracle database. For the demonstration, I'm going to create a very simple package which will consist of two elements, a function and a stored procedure. So let's start with creating the header of the package. Here we have the header. I think this package header is quite neat. Just by looking at it, we can say that the name of the package will be pkg_rebellionwriter and there will be two package elements. First is a PLSQL function with name prnt_strng with return data type varchar2. And second is a stored procedure with name proc_superhero with two parameters f_name and l_name. That's all we will be having in this package. Let's compile this package header. Here we are. In order to provide some meaning to this package header, we need to write the package body where we will write the code for the function and procedure which we have in our package. So let's do it. Let me write this package body on a fresh worksheet. I guess that will be clearer. And here we have our fresh worksheet. Great! So in the package body, we have implemented both the package elements which we defined in the package header. As you can see, the PLSQL function prnt_strng is returning the string of varchar2 type, which is the name of my blog rebellionwriter.com. Also the procedure proc_superhero is accepting two parameters fname and lname and inserting those values into a table new superheroes. I have been asked many questions about these superheroes tables. These are nothing but just tables which I create according to the need for the demonstration in the tutorial. For example, the new superheroes table which I created for this tutorial. You can see the structure of this table on your screen. By judging from the structure, you can see it is a very simple table with only two columns. Anyways, now that we have written the implementing code for all our package elements, next we have to compile the package body. Package body compiled successfully. This means that now we have our package ready for use. But how? How can we access and use the package elements? Let's move further and learn how to use the package elements in our PLSQL code. As it is apparently clear that our package has two package elements. One is the PLSQL function and second is the stored procedure. So let's write the code and try to access them. What do you suggest? Should we start with the PLSQL function or the stored procedure? Okay, it is PLSQL function then. Here Here, I have a very simple anonymous block which consists of only one DBMS output statement, inside which I have called the PRNT underscore string function of PKG underscore rebellion rider package. On execution of this block, we will see the string rebellionrider.com. Let's execute and see the result. But remember, in order to see the result, you need to first set the server output on. Now, let's execute. Here is the result. Similarly, you can execute the stored procedure. Let me first clear the screen and close this output panel. Done. Before calling the procedure, first let's see whether we have some data in the underlying table new underscore superheroes into which our procedure is inserting the data. No row returns, which means no data. Now let's execute the procedure of our package. Here, again for calling the procedure, I use the anonymous block into which I call the procedure proc underscore superhero. To do so, I first wrote the name of the package followed by the dot operator and then the name of our procedure along with the valid parameter values. Let's execute this code and see whether it works or not. PLSQL procedure executed successfully. Now let's check whether we have this new superhero entry inserted into the table or not. Here it is. You can refer to my blog on how to create PLSQL function and stored procedure to learn different ways of calling them. Links are in the description. And that is how we create a PLSQL package in Oracle database and access its elements into the code. Hope you find this PLSQL tutorial helpful. If so, then give this video a big thumbs up and help others in learning by sharing this tutorial video on your social media with your friends. Also, do make sure to subscribe. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. I will be back soon with more interesting tutorials. Till then, take care. This is Manish from rebellionrider.com.